Out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water. It don't mean cursing and gossiping and running your brothers and sisters down. It don't mean judging one another. Out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water. There's power, there's life and there's death and the power of the tongue. Wonder how many is speaking life, wonder how many of us is speaking death. He took me fishing while I was out there. And believe it or not, he seen me catch my first fish with him. And I told him, I says, hey, I told him earlier as he caught one, I said, you ought to cut the head off of that thing and put it out there and fish with it. I'm telling you this not to be funny. A little later, a young boy done that. We were sitting there fishing, and all of a sudden a shark come in there and just snatched it. Snatched that boy, so right off the top of the water. Shark about 4 or 5 feet long, just grabbed it and went. Took it out of the water to death, it wore him out. I say that to say this. We were all fishing. We were all believers. But there was a shark in the water ready to grab and attack. Right there, people swimming within 100 yards. It's sharp big enough to bite you. Same way with you people. We'll come in here and shout hallelujah. Say we're believers. And we'll walk right out that door right there. The shark's sitting right outside that door ready to bite you. He's ready to sneak attack on you. He's ready to get in your mind, get in your mouth, get in your heart. And out of your belly, the dam just stops up. You quit talking that love. You quit talking that Jesus. You quit talking the scriptures. Come on, I'm hitting somebody. He just quit. He should have never given me this. See, he opened up the worms. I'm fixing to pull them out. Out of our bellies shall flow rivers of living water. And we do need to get back to the rock. He put us on the rock. Listen, I'm saved tonight and I know it. And I won't lose my salvation, but I can lose my testimony. I can lose my rewards. I can go outside that building right there and cuss. I can cuss like a sailor.
Oh, no.
I can do it. But I choose not to because I don't want to take his chastisement and his witness. I don't want to lose my reward. I can go out there and buy me a quart of Jack Daniels and take it home and drink it. I can't walk. But I choose not to. The Bible says, come out from amongst it.
Hallelujah.
I don't want nothing to damn my spirit up. I want to flow with the living water. Amen. That's when I can look in the mirror and say, big boy, you might be old and gray-headed tonight, but greater is he is in you than he is in the world, saith the word of God. Amen. I can look in that same mirror and see that old man in there. I said, son, you're going to live for eternity because your name written in the Lamb's book of life. Why? Because out of my belly, I'm a believer, and out of my belly is going to flow rivers. Amen. I don't want it dammed up. And that old rocks and seashells will come through. It'll damn your spirit up if you let it. But I refuse tonight to let the devil stick up a damn in my spirit world. How many of y'all going to agree with me? You ought to stand up your feet and say, devil, I'm getting tired of my God. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hey. Keep standing. He's done closed. This is the invitation. I'm proud of that boy. I ain't giving him no lessons. I ain't showed him nothing. Open the heart. And yeah, he's still got a lot of growing to do. That's exactly right. Got a lot of growing to do. But I can't let him grow. I can't make him grow. God's got to do it. Son, he is going to take some things out of your life. And you might go out to the corner and cry like a baby, but don't worry about it. He's going to replace them with something a whole lot better.
Amen.
Yes. Yes.
You're going to have sin coming all around you.
That's right.
Devil can't stand it. But you're right, it all starts at home. With daddy. I've had all kinds of stuff come through me. about Jehovah's Spirit within me? What about you? Don't look at me like you're perfect. Nobody in here perfect. Neither am I. A bunch of you still got hangouts. A bunch of you still got problems. Why don't you give them to God? I'm stirred up right now. I'm stirred up. This road to recovery, whatever they call it up here, it's fixing to be a change. This is going to be a road to freedom or something. Amen?
Amen.
I want you to get, listen, if you got a problem, I want to tell you what to take care of your problem tonight. If you got any kind of problem in your life, I'm going to tell you what to take care of. His name is Jesus.
Amen.
Get on in the water. Let the water start flowing within you. Let the Spirit of God wash your mind. Let it wash your soul. Let the love of Christ come out. Listen, if you got hate in your heart tonight, that ain't a Jesus. If you can't wait to start talking about me, that ain't a Jesus. And my friend, if you can't look at somebody and tell them the truth, don't tell them a lie. Just keep your mouth shut and mind your own business. Because the truth will set you free.
Amen.
Where are we at tonight, church? Where are we at? You know that's what I like about this little church? And as long as my name is out there on the sign, and I'm a pastor here, it'll be this way. I'm going to tell you what way it is. The Word of God will be preached here.
Amen.
It will not be watered down. It will not be sugar-coated. It will not be preached just to tickle your ears.
Amen.
We might not ever be a giant clubhouse. We might not ever be a rock and roll house. But I'm going to tell you what a flow get here. As long as God's got me planted here, Pastor Timothy, out of that pulpit up there, it's going to flow rivers. And I hope the rivers is going to flood this place. I hope the Holy Spirit's going to run over everybody's head, everybody's heart. I hope the Holy Spirit's going to chase the devil all the way back to hell where he comes from. But y'all ain't getting what I'm trying to lay down here for you, are you? You need to look at somebody and say, I'm going to stand tonight for what I believe in. And I believe in Jesus. How many of you going to stand up for Jesus? How many of you glad he stood up for you? I said, how many of you glad he stood up for you? Look at somebody and say, it's our time to get charged up to stand for Jesus. Somebody ought to shout.
Amen. Glory. Glory, glory. Glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Out of your bellies shall flow. 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 That means not a trickle. A trickle means when you come in on a Sunday morning and say, amen, preacher. And go eat dinner and cuss me out while you're eating mashed potatoes. That's a trickle. But when it starts to flow, that's what you can say, man, I'm getting blessed today. Man, I love the singing today. Man, I love this baby today. Man, it's been good to be in God's house today. You know what? I didn't even look at my watch. Man, it's been good. I just felt the love in the house. I felt freedom in the house. I didn't even want to go. That's when it starts to flow. And the next thing, you go home and get the scripture out, get it off the coffee table. You read a little bit of it. And then it get implanted in your mind and in your heart. And in about 3 or 4 weeks, you'll get up in that right foot and start jumping up and say, praise the Lamb of God. I feel like I'm on the mountaintop. And when the devil comes your way, big and jumped on, you can go to your door and say, Azale, you ain't coming in my house because I'm a child of God. And lure little tap tanks and say, hey, the Bible says there ain't a weapon that ever be formed to prosper against you. And it won't, praise God. But the Bible also said it didn't say the weapon wouldn't be formed. It just said it would not prosper. I thank God. It don't matter what kind of weapon will be formed. It ain't going to prosper if you're a child of God. How many of you believe what I'm preaching to you right now? You ought to have both hands up and say, Lord Jesus, I receive it right now in the name of Jesus. Somebody, this is good stuff, Jack. I'm glad you give me that tonight. Out of your bellies shall flow rivers of living water. Now, I'm closing with this. He doesn't close. I'm closing now. What's coming out of your belly? What come out of your belly today? What come out of your belly on the way to church? And what's going to come out of your belly on the way home? I'm not going to ask for your hands. That's between you and Jesus. What you standing on tonight? You still on the rock. Now Jesus said he put you on the rock. He didn't push you off. Now you can slide. You might just be dying on. But he's right here with you. He ain't never left and saved you. He's right here with you tonight. He's ready to grab your arm and put your feet back where they need to be. That's on the rock. You think about that. What's your vocabulary been? What's your mindset been? What you been looking at? What you been daydreaming about? Father, we thank you. I thank you for Jack's message. It stirred me. We give you praise for it. Lord, you showed me this a long, long time ago that for a believer, you ain't got to have no stamp on your forehead. You ain't got to wear a t-shirt because you can just get around a believer and hear that river flowing. You can feel the river flowing. What a cool breeze it is when the Holy Spirit takes charge. Touch these people tonight. Holy Spirit, I'm doing exactly what you showed me to do. I'm not even going to ask for a show of hands. I just want these people to get hold of the word tonight. Let the river flow through you tonight. Oh yeah, I'm going to say this. Do you know the Lord as your Savior? If you don't, all you have to do is believe in your heart. If he showed you that tonight, say, Lord Jesus, I believe you. I believe in you. And I ask you right now to forgive me of these sins. As this brother said, the seashells and the sand and all the debris went by and were gone. Take that out of my life. As I accept you right now as my Savior. Thank you, Lord, for what you've done for me this night. If you said that prayer, we want you to know Jesus has saved you. Are you going to be perfect? No, you will not be perfect. But you'll be saved. Listen, my friend. Get in the church. Stay in church. Get in the Bible, read that word, hear that word, and eventually that river's going to open up and flow, and you're going to be blessed. Preacher, I said that prayer with you while I did that. I ever, I close, I'm going to